Actually, I think we were maybe frenemies our first year, and people were quite surprised when we decided to launch IDEA, or when he decided to launch, you know, the school within a school that I kind of signed up and got on board. And that we partnered to do that. And it wasn't so much that we were frenemies, but we were both very competitive by nature. And so, you know, we were always competing in terms of student results when those were coming out. They had door decorating contests at our school that would get very vicious between Tom and I in terms of whose groups of kids would win. So when Mike Feinberg came and started talking about this KIPP program that he was doing in Houston, I think folks were shocked that Tom and I, you know, kind of partnered up and said, like, hey, let's get in the car and let's drive to Houston and let's see what it is that they're doing. Obviously for two reasons. One, you know, the results that he was talking about really resonated with us. But secondly, and really personally, KIPP was founded in the neighborhood in which I grew up in Houston. And in fact, Garcia Elementary is less than a mile away from the elementary school that I attended. It was built for overflow purposes, and so I had a lot of nieces and nephews there. I think I was actually shocked to hear you know, to hear him talk about this community and how far behind the kids were, and you know, how this community needed good schools, because, you know, you have to put it in the context of that's the community that I grew up in. And so I never realized that I was poor. I never really realized that I went to a bad school. I never really realized that, you know, wow, he's talking about not wanting to send his group of fifth graders to Patrick Henry Middle School, which is where I went to middle school. Yeah, so at the end of my second year, I decided to go home to Houston, and my father had actually died at the end of my first year of teaching, and this is kind of where Tom really became endearing to me. So I think it was like the last week of school, my father passed away. And so there was so much to do in terms of closing out the school year and grades and promoting kids and conversations with parents. And I just had to drop everything and leave. And I just remember calling my principal and her saying, don't worry about it. Like, we didn't even get you a sub. Tom took all your kids. He has them in his class. He's, you know, doing your report cards. He's having those conversations with families. And so I went back, you know, obviously for my second year, but my brother had a really hard time with my dad's passing. So at the end of my second year commitment, I decided to go home to Houston. And Tom, you know, stayed in the Valley and moved IDEA, because they shut down the school where IDEA was founded, moved it to another elementary school, and just didn't have the same support from the new leader there. And so obviously we were conversing via phone, and he was just talking about how, you know, he had to find a new partner, new teachers to help, how the principal wasn't as supportive, she wasn't really letting him keep his kids longer, wasn't letting them come in on Saturday. And he said, hey, you know, KIPP, and yes, I don't know if you know, they've applied for charter status and they've gotten their charter status. I think I'm gonna apply for a charter. I'm gonna start writing a charter. And I remember he would email me some of the sections of the charter to read and review. And at one point he said, like, if I get this, will you come back? And I said, yeah. And I was like, he's never gonna get it. I mean, like, we've been teaching, you know, he's been teaching for 2.5 years. Like, who's gonna give a person who's been teaching for 2.5 years, like, permission to run their own district? So I was like, of course, yeah, I'll come back. If you get it, I'll come back. And then I just remember getting a phone call saying, how soon can you be here? And I said, well, school ends on, I remember the exact day, I was like, school ends May 30th. And he said, I'll see you on the 31st. And so in a day, I packed up and moved, and remember just spent the entire summer writing curriculum and finding teachers and buying buses and looking for, you know, facilities to rent, to lease, to house our school. And going back, I mean, the most exciting part was going back and finding the original fourth graders that we both taught our first year, which by this time were in the middle school. And going back into those families, you know, finding those families, going into the colonias, knocking on doors, and we had this whole pitch of how we were going to convince the families to, like, come to our school, and we practiced this pitch, and we're like, we have to be really compelling, we have to convince our families to come to, like, this school that doesn't exist. When they ask, where is it at, like, we don't really have a location. And it was probably the easiest part of launching the school. Parents are like, yes, we'll be there. And go next door to the neighbor and tell the neighbor, because the neighbor wants to go too, and the neighbor's gonna be there as well. So just the student recruitment piece was like the easiest part of what we did that first year.